Hey, my name is Gene Wardlow, and this is George Pedroza in assembly. I'm the production manager here today. And what we're here is to show you how we assemble a variety of units. We're gonna start with the Sentry 4 stainless steel. It's gonna be in a 24 bolt pattern, automatic. And we're going step by step into the operations of assembly. First of all, what we do is we take the automatic button itself and we screw in an elbow. It's a 90 slip connection elbow into the valve. George, you can go ahead and start with all the assembly as I go through it. It goes into the end port of the brass automatic valve. So what he's gonna do is tighten it in. Should take no more than a minute to do this. And you wanna tighten it snug, not too tight. Remember, you're going into a brass fitting itself. The brass fitting is very soft metal, so we're going in very slight, nice and taut, or not too tight. Okay, now we apply the Loctite into the outer diameter threads and will be screwed into the part itself on the internal housing. There you go. We do this in order to keep the valve steady to where it won't vibrate during operation and creates a seal. Because this is the air side of the unit, and as it air is let into the unit by the discharge pressure, it will fill the vessel. Apply just a little bit. Okay, all hand tight. Then he uses a specialized tool that we've created here. It's a special fixture that will go right over the top of the valve. You can use this in the field as like a pair of channel locks, or a bigger wrenched vice grips would work too. But what we do is we tighten it snug with the hand tight, and then we do a little bit of tightening, not over tighten. Remember, this is very soft metal, okay? To where you cannot take it apart with your hands. Then the finished good will be nice and flush with the body internally, and there is the other side. This would be the exposed side, okay? Now what we do is take an automatic valve, I'm sorry, a one-way check valve, and we Teflon tape the, there's two different ways of putting this valve in it. There's a small arrow. This arrow indicates the airflow. And this arrow designates the air will be traveling in this direction, in this direction. So we'll have to Teflon coat the other side in order to put into the body. You will notice that there's two ports on either side of this valve. Those are quarter inch NPT ports. And it really doesn't make one bit of difference what side this goes into. So I'll leave that up to you to decide in the field. But we're gonna go ahead and pick the one to your left. Go ahead and tighten it in there, George. Now we're gonna do this hand tight because on the other end of this is gonna go the other 90 degree elbow. Yeah.
What I'm gonna do.
Okay. This is a directional one-way valve. There's a small arrow here that indicates the direction of air. We want the direction of air going into the vessel itself. So we will be installing this valve in this port so the air will allow to fill when needed. We hand tighten the side. You will flip the top housing over, and George, go ahead and install that elbow. And as he's screwing this elbow on, you're tightening one side into the valve and holding it secure on the other end. That way you're not collapsing the tapered thread and having a nice, even, smooth, tightened, go ahead and use it. And again, this needs to be tightened snug, not too tight. You don't want to damage the threads. It is a soft material. Now, there isn't a specific length that we always use in order to install this quarter inch vinyl tubing. But what we do is we measure it out. And in measuring and doing so, you'll have a nice sweep. You don't want to have too much tension or you'll kink the hose. Once you kink the hose, it will be damaged. Go ahead and cut right there. Now what he's going to do here is he's going to wet each end. In order to create a nice firm fit, we wet the ends, and this also helps it to seal better. And it's just push connections hand tight, and he's going to make a nice sweep. And then once it's done, we lay it down flush with the body to contour with the body. Now what we do is plug the outer port. For testing, just go ahead and plug it this end here. That's good. Now we just hand tight on this side. We'll plug the hole, and what we're trying to achieve here is we're going to fill the vessel with water. When the vessel is filled, we submerge all fittings and we do an air or bubble test to make sure that we have no leakage. Okay? So we hook up a one-way check valve to the air inlet side with a quick connect. And this will allow air to be forced into the air valve. Now what we do is fill the vessel with water. What we're looking for is any kind of residual air leaks. And that will tell us if it's a bad diaphragm or a bad fit. Since there is no leaks, we can determine that the automatic valve is functioning properly. So disconnection, we dry out the vessel. What we do now is once the vessel is dry, we'll put the automatic button to complete the version of the automatic. And first we put the spring in. Then we follow up with the aluminum button. And that's held together by a set screw. And when we tighten that, then the automatic function internally is complete. And then it's off to further assembly. Before we install the bladder or the Teflon backup diaphragm or the Teflon diaphragm itself, we apply the Gore-Tex tape. It has a half inch width with adhesive on the back. And we will apply it on the inner diameter of the bolt pattern. Like so. Go ahead, George, you can complete it. Okay, next step is we grab the backup diaphragm. This is a diaphragm made out of Buna. It has a mesh interior to keep the flex value and to keep the air from traveling and pushing out the bladder, which deforms our Teflon bladder. So we'll put this in the convexed position on the top half. Line up the bolt holes. Then we take the Teflon diaphragm. As we put the diaphragm in, we match the bolt holes. Then we use the 7/16 stainless steel bolt along with the washer. We put it on the undercarriage of the top and gently push it through both diaphragms. We do that 24 times around the top half. Go ahead. Once you install the bolt, you gently turn it over and set it in the receiving part of the bottom bolt pattern. And gently place it and push the bolt through the bottom half. Once that's done, we will use an anti-seizing lube. We call it Moly-D, or you can use a variety of other anti-seizing compounds. What we use here at Blacoh is Moly-D lube, and you apply. We apply the grease on the threads itself. Simple application, not too heavy, nice and light, all the way around. This keeps the bolts and nuts from seizing, which will create a very costly and time-consuming problem. So once that's applied, we put the nuts on all 24 bolts by hand. Once the nuts have been screwed onto the bolts, we will do in a crosshatch pattern from point A to point B continuously across the body until snug. We use a air ratchet, pneumatic, to do this feature. Go ahead, George, show them your magic. Once the unit has been tightened, we follow up with a torque wrench. We will tighten to 20 foot-pounds of torque for this application because overnight it will settle and will have to be retightened in the field. There's tagging that will tell you that. But before it leaves the facility, we'll retighten and check the torque before it gets boxed up and packaged and handled. So go ahead. And again, we'll do a crosshatch pattern from point A to point B, so on and so on, until it is completely torqued. He indicates a mark to where he knows where he started from. Once it's complete and torqued to the proper torque specs at 20 foot-pounds of torque, it goes into testing. There it will have a charge of 120 psi or whatever standard pressure it is overnight. And once it passes, it will go into packaging handling for future inspection. But as of right now, this model is completely assembled. There we go.